What did the plants look like during the Age of Dinosaurs? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, we're going to look at the plants that lived during the Mesozoic Era and how they changed during this 252 million year span of time. Now, during the Triassic and Jurassic, the entire plant kingdom was composed of non-flowering plants. Now, think of all of the plants that you interact with on a daily basis, from the wheat in the flour that makes your bread of your peanut butter and jelly sandwich, to the strawberries in the jelly, to the peanut in the peanut butter. Nearly all the plants that we consume are flowering plants, and none of these plants were around during the Triassic and Jurassic, including grasses, for example. So what type of plants were there? Now, instead of grass, the fields would be full of sphenopsids. These are the horsetails. Now, these are still living today, but unlike grass that requires seeds and flowers, these plants are fertilized by the groundwater during the rainy seasons. Now, they were common in the Triassic and Jurassic, becoming rare during the Cretaceous. Now, the sphenopsids, like horsetails, were likely a source of food for the dinosaurs during the Jurassic period. Now, what's interesting about these plants is that they can only grow where there's enough water for fertilization, which means that the arid regions lacked plants, and the arid regions of the Earth would be even more depleted of plants than they are today. The next common undergrowth plants are the ferns, which are very diverse today, and they grow in wet, rainy regions as well. And this is because they too require water for fertilization. Now, not all plants during the Mesozoic required water for fertilization. Cycads only require wind pollination, and some have insect pollination, in which pollen from the male plants is transferred to the female plants, and this allows for fertilization without water. These plants today grow in warm, tropical climates, and they don't do well in cold regions. Now, cycads produce seeds, and they have these big leafy fronds, but very few of them are eaten by animals, as many of them can be toxic. The largest group of trees living during the Mesozoic period are the gymnosperms, the naked seed plants, which grow worldwide today, and they include such groups as the conifers, such as pine and juniper. They could grow in more arid regions and would have larger temperature tolerances. Now, some of these can grow to giant sizes, such as the redwood trees, and they were the largest of the trees of the Mesozoic. Now, these trees were perhaps food for the giant sauropod dinosaurs that lived during the Jurassic period. Now, the next group of Mesozoic plants are the ginkgos, which are a really unique tree that has wind pollination and was common during the Jurassic period. They look more like a normal tree, and that is because they have these broader leaves that you see, but they do not produce flowers. Instead, they produce seeds, which are somewhat edible. People can eat these seeds of ginkgos, and the ginkgos were common during the Triassic and Jurassic periods. The angiosperms, or flowering plants, only started to begin to appear in the Cretaceous period. Any plant that produces flowers is an angiosperm, and this includes all the grasses, all the fruit trees, cactus, oh man, much of the food that we mammals eat. But they only appear until the Cretaceous period. Now, the oldest angiosperm and the oldest flower is found in the early Cretaceous Yixing Formation in China, which is the same layer of rocks that produces many of the feathered dinosaurs. This is Archaea fructus, which is the oldest flowering plant known. So dinosaurs, during their reign on Earth, saw a profound change in the flora during the early Cretaceous period. During the Cretaceous, the flowering plants took off in diversity, and this had a profound effect on the food available to the dinosaurs. And this might explain why the dinosaurs during the late Cretaceous were much more numerous than they were during the Jurassic period. Most Jurassic herbivores did not appear to grind vegetation with their teeth. And they may have been dependent on softer vegetation or using gastroliths in their stomach to grind vegetation. Now, many Jurassic herbivores appear to have these nipping teeth that would be useful if they were feeding on, say, horsetails, but did not appear to do much chewing of the plant material that they ate. If we look at herbivores in the Cretaceous period, they have batteries of teeth that are specialized for chewing. We see this in the ceratopsian and ornithopod dinosaurs, and they had many more different types of plants to feed on, including broadleaf flowering plants. Now, these dinosaurs evolved the ability to chew and eat these new sources of food. If we look at the diversity of dinosaurs during the late Cretaceous, especially that of the ornithischian dinosaurs, they become much more diverse, and many of these are chewing dinosaurs during this period of time. This is often called the flowering of the dinosaurs because of the appearance of flowering plants during this time. Okay, you should now be able to identify the different types of plants that were living during the Mesozoic era and how these plants changed over time. Also, synthesize what we mean by dinosaurs co-evolved with plants.